We have seen one piece of cyber legislation after another, from SOPA to PIPA to CISPA to FISA. The list goes on. And they're all bills aimed to regulate the internet and stifle citizens' internet freedoms. And each time, there is public backlash against the murky language in the legislation and how they can create a slippery slope away from our online experience as we know it. But just how much does Congress really understand about the cyber world and cybersecurity? Who could forget about this famous comment back in 2006 by the late senator from Alaska, Ted Stevens?
And here we have this one situation where enormous entities want to use the internet for their purpose to save money for doing what they're doing now. They use FedEx, they use the delivery services, they use the mail, they deliver in other ways, but they want to deliver vast amounts of information over the internet. And again, the internet is not something that you just dump something on. It's not a big truck. It's a series of tubes.
Series of tubes, he says. So is Congress out of touch when it comes to cybersecurity? And what these controversial pieces of legislation really mean for our internet freedoms? To discuss this and more, John Simpson, Privacy Project Director with Consumer Watchdog, joins us now. Welcome, John. Nice to have you
here
in the studio. So, John, Congress, you know, a lot of older guys maybe didn't grow up with the internet, and
I'm one of those old guys.
But the young people, you know, they do grow up with the internet. So is it possible that Congress is out of touch with the cyber world?
I think Congress is desperately trying to catch up and trying to do the right thing in a lot of places, but there are all sorts of pitfalls. And one of the biggest ones, I think, is when things are done in the name of security, which really end up perhaps invading your privacy in ways that are inappropriate.
And you know, we see controversial bills aiming to tackle that. You know, we see bills like PIPA, like SOPA, like CISPA, some more, the list goes on. And every time there is a backlash from online activists, so why do they keep pushing for legislation like this?
Well, I mean, I think legislators see their job is to legislate, and so they're trying to catch up with what they perceive to be problems. And the difficulty is that some of these issues are very, very hard to get your head around. And when you do get something like security, when you feel that your entire electronic grid could be threatened by cyber attacks, the natural reaction is to say, oh, we've got to pass the equivalent of the Patriot Act. And that's just a wrong-headed approach. I mean, this would give too much authority to government to look over your shoulder and delve into all sorts of communications and things like that, that would be completely inappropriate.
So you're saying it's a natural reaction. Do you think that it's a fair reaction or a justified reaction?
I think it's a natural reaction. It often ends up being an inappropriate one.
And, you know, I wanted to bring up this fact, you know, the way that people communicate these days, vastly different from in the past. You know, we use social media, things like Facebook, like Twitter, other social media sites. And some of these congressmen are at least trying to keep up with the times. Let's take a look at some of their tweets. They're kind of interesting. The first one is, I don't know, there's a hashtag 99, county meetings, Clinton, Lyondell Industries, tour/Q&A with 110 people, including others, issues, EPA regs, fracking, FNF creates jobs. It goes on. And then there's another one there. Stopped at McDonald's for a milkshake. Couldn't find a Dairy Queen in this part of the DSM. So
they're trying to be trying.
But one of them doesn't make any sense, and the other one is just kind of silly. So does it just is this just another sign that they're kind of out of touch?
Well, you know, it's a sign that they're trying to adopt to use social media and use the media appropriately. One of the problems with that whole thing, though, for the rest of us, for everybody, is the extent to which our communications and our activity on the internet are monitored and used by companies to sell us, essentially to sell us to advertisers. And there is a need for some sort of appropriate regulation to give consumers the right to control the information that's gathered about them when they surf the web when they send messages, when they send emails. That's very, very important. And I think Congress needs to understand some of those issues. And I think that there is a growing awareness of the problems with that that was manifested by a privacy report that came out of the Commerce Department and also a report that came out of the Federal Trade Commission, and the Federal Trade Commission calling for a mechanism called Do Not Track, which would give consumers the ability not to have their data gathered and tracked when they surf the web. That's very important.
You know, and a lot of the concern from online activists is the fact that the language in this bill is very murky, and it could take us down this slippery slope where it creates this potential for this kind of regulation and this invasion of privacy. And it's this kind of language that people have really spoken out against. Why do you think that there isn't more of an effort to try to put those safeguards within these bills to prevent that possibility and to satisfy people that are concerned about their online freedoms?
It's very difficult to get some of this reduced to legislative language. And there are right now some efforts where there are so-called multi-stakeholder groups trying to establish standards that make sense, both by from the business side, but also by involving representatives of civil society and NGOs like me. There's something called the World Wide Web Consortium that is trying to establish standards that provide the necessary controls but still allow there to be innovation on the internet, which is key.
Mm-hmm. And you know, this all comes down to cybersecurity, as the lawmakers put it, and they've kind of instilled this fear that this is something that we really need to be concerned about, even scared about, these kinds of cyber threats. Do you think it's a legitimate threat?
I think that it often is overhyped, and you can do an awful lot of damage in the name of security. Now, it's ironic. The two of the biggest sort of cyber threats most recently were a thing called Stuxnet, I'm sorry, and Flame, which are two computer viruses that probably the United States and Israel cooked up and put onto computers in Iran. So we're out there posing cyber threats. It's a little bit hypocritical to, maybe that shows why we think we need the need, but there's a great danger that too much can be overdone, all in the name of security.
Very interesting. John, thank you so much for coming on the show. That was John Simpson, Privacy Project Director with Consumer Watchdog.